According to FlightAware, as of now, there's been 63 cancellations in the last 24 hours, 32 cancellations just today, and 245 flight delays.
The United States Supreme Court has just overturned Roe versus Wade. Here in New York City at Washington Square Park, people have gathered and they're rallying against that decision.
A father and son were in Orlando visiting UCF for a college orientation, but troopers say they were killed in a car accident by a woman driving under the influence.
This is the second year Marion County Schools is hosting their hometown hiring career fair.
A winter snowstorm has slammed the northeast coast of the country, leaving up to 2 feet of snow in areas like Boston, Massachusetts, and up to 10 inches of snow here in New York City.
Protesters behind me are supporting the Green New Deal for the state of New York.
With the 2022 midterm elections less than 2 weeks away, Woodward and Bernstein are reminding journalists that they play a pivotal role in defending democracy.
Here in New York City, it happens every year. People come from all over the world celebrating Pride. Here in Greenwich Village, you see honking all over the streets.
With major bipartisan support, the House today gave final congressional approval to a landmark bill that guarantees federal recognition of same-sex and interracial marriages. Ali Vitali has that story.
Finally, the hero dog on a mission of compassion and acceptance. And he's inspiring America.
Ahead of one of the busiest travel days of the year, Orlando International Airport is facing some possible ground stops, leading to cancellations and delays affecting passengers. We spoke to some travelers who are just wanting a smoother experience.
Please don't let it happen again.
The wait times for the TSA security checkpoint are what usually have travelers stressing. But today, with delays and cancellations across the country, people have a new headache.
I want to get home.
Denise Lykosz, frustrated after arriving to the airport, only to find her flight is canceled. The FAA, in a video on Twitter, blaming the delays and cancellations on weather, calling it a domino effect that means crews can't get to where they need to, and for some airports, too many planes stuck, resulting in ground stops. According to the FAA's website, there are a number of airports with ground stops possible, including Orlando International Airport.
I was flying back to New Jersey from West Palm Beach, and my son dropped me off, and all the flights got canceled. And so the first thing I can get on was out of Orlando on Friday.
Over 22,000 flights have been delayed today, and more than 1,500 already canceled, according to FlightAware. The weather only adding to staffing issues highlighted in a report out last week by the U.S. Department of Transportation, in which they say about 77% of the FAA's critical facilities are staffed below the 85% threshold. One more thing travelers say they now have to worry about when planning a trip.
It's basically the space that we're in right now, but just hoping that everyone who works for the FAA and moving forward does everything that they can to fix it so that we can have smoother flying experiences. You know, we know we're still trying to get back to 100% since COVID, but that means hiring more faculty staff, paying attention to those questionnaires and surveys and things like that, and making sure everybody has a better experience.
According to FlightAware, as of now, there's been 63 cancellations in the last 24 hours, 32 cancellations just today, and 245 flight delays. From Orlando International Airport, I'm Edward Franco, getting results, News 6.
50 years ago, here at the Watergate Hotel, a break-in took place that led to the downfall of the president. Journalists Bob Woodward and Carl Bernstein uncovered it all. Now today, they warn of another threat to our democracy.
I talked to Trump on the
phone. While speaking at MediaFest 22, Woodward read from former President Nixon's recorded conversations, warning journalists that what Nixon said is similar to how former President Trump speaks.
And also, never forget, the press is the enemy. The press is the enemy. The press is the enemy. Write that on a blackboard 100 times and never forget it.
Wow.
Now, who else talks like this? Not just Richard Nixon, but Donald Trump.
As political officials attack journalists, Bernstein says that reporters need to focus on obtaining the best version of the truth.
The truth is not neutral. We have an obligation to be fair, to present both sides, but it doesn't mean giving equal amounts of space. The idea that we have to split down the middle is is a real handicap.
Both journalists believe in the power of showing up fairly, something they don't think happens enough today.
For everyone here, there is a lot of work to do, and write that on the blackboard 100 times.
Woodward and Bernstein continue to show up, knocking on doors and making phone calls, as that is what they believe is necessary to uncovering the truth.
With the 2022 midterm elections less than 2 weeks away, Woodward and Bernstein are reminding journalists that they play a pivotal role in defending democracy and that there's still much work to be done. I'm Edward Franco, reporting for the SBJ News, Washington, D.C.